Tonight at 11, rumbling in the I-96 construction zone isn't just about the noise tonight. Yep, it's loud. But that heavy equipment also packs quite a punch, and at least one homeowner living in the shadow of this project say it's damaging his home. 7 Action News reporter Julie Bonovich standing by live tonight in Livonia. And Julie, it sounds like a mess out there right now.
It is, Stephen. It still is. And we'll show you that man's home in a second, but just want to show you out here. Crews were working all the way up until just now. It appears that some of them have stopped. Not sure if they're stopping for the rest of the night. They told us that they were supposed to stop the loud pounding and banging by 11 o'clock. Well, we want to show you what this one man says he thinks all that banging did to his home. That constant drilling is what Peter Shaw deals with next to his home all night and day.
You can not only hear this, you can feel this.
He's right. You can see the plants shaking on the table. And there was no wind, but the water rippled over the pool.
We had pounding, 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 and it's just continual.
The vibrations from the construction along I-96 so strong, you get a little bit of a surprise when you use the bathroom.
If I'm sitting on the throne, I have a vibrating toilet, thanks to the new construction of MDOT.
But Shaw's biggest concern is structural damage to his home.
I am concerned about potential damage to my poured basement walls.
When Shaw took us to his basement to show us what he means.
Here we go. Son of a.
He wasn't happy to see a crack in the wall that he says wasn't there yesterday.
Whatever they were doing, stuff was just dropping like 1,000 pounds worth of God knows what, and we felt it all night.
Shaw says he knows the freeway needs to be repaired. He drives I-96 to work every day.
I understand they have a project to do. Yeah, it's got to get done. I would have wished it would have been done in stages.
But MDOT has said working in stages would make the project go even longer than the October deadline. So you can definitely see some of the frustrations, very real frustrations of people out here. Now, we did call MDOT several times tonight about the problem with Shaw's house, but they didn't return our phone calls yet. We're live from Livonia, Julie Bonovich, 7 Action News.
All right, thanks, Julie.